Good afternoon, you guys. Hello, it's Katie. It's so good to see y'all. I'm so happy you could be here today. Hey guys, oh my goodness. So ever since I got my hair dyed blue, I had like the idea where I was like, oh my goodness, I should dress like Evie. If you guys don't know who Evie is, she is a Descendants character, Disney Descendants, Disney Channel, if that rings any bells. If you guys have been here for a good minute, you all would know I absolutely love. Whoa, what was that? I absolutely love with all my heart Descendants. I am a huge fan. I'm one of their biggest fans. I've loved it since before it even came out, like since its announcement, like literally even before it was like created, because I loved things like Ever After High. I was just always obsessed with things like this. So it was just amazing when they announced like, we're gonna be doing villain kids on for Disney Channel. I was like, sign me up. Y'all know I love Disney with all my heart. I love the villains. I love all the characters. And so I always find it like really fun when they do things like this, making like their kids. Like, I love it. I always love this. So I was super excited, and I've loved every movie. I love them with all my heart. I love the cast. I love the characters. I just love the music. I love the music, etc., etc., etc. You guys know I love it with all my heart. So anyways, I'm also addicted to Kennedy. If you guys don't know who Kennedy Walsh is, she's an amazing YouTuber. I highly recommend. She's one of my faves. She makes videos where she dresses like characters for like a week and whatnot. And I just love watching those videos. And every time I watch those videos, I'm like, oh my goodness, I want to do this. So that mind frame mixed with now I had blue hair was like combined, and I was like, oh my gosh, I always want to do videos like that. Now I have the blue hair, so let me dress like Evie for a little, you know, that'll be so fun. So that's where this video idea was born. So unfortunately I only have like two outfits. I actually, like, one of the days is actually today, and I switched outfits. It's right there. But I wanted to like throw in a bonus little thing of like another blue shirt, you know, because I thought that'd be fun for the intro. I'm actually filming the intro and like the outro like last ish because I've already filmed the days, and now I'm filming the intro and the outro, and I'm gonna start editing it. When I get like a video idea, I immediately just want to film it and do it, because I always get like, I'm really bad. First off, my patience is not always great, so that's why I'm kind of like that. I'm like, oh my gosh, I need to go now and do it. But another thing is, I sometimes, like, if I wait to film something, it just sometimes never gets filmed. Like, I still remember from a couple months ago in quarantine, I like made a list of videos I wanted to film, but since I didn't do them immediately, I never got around to filming them, and I ended up forgetting about most of them. You know what I mean? Like, it just, that's how I am sometimes. So unfortunately it's only like two outfits, but truly, they were like my true Evie outfits of like, you'll see, like, you'll know 100% they're like my true Evie outfits. The rest of the outfits would just be like blue and red outfits. Like, they wouldn't actually like have like, you know, key Evil Queen features on them. Like, see, like, this is just a blue and white tie dye. You know what I mean? Like, it wouldn't be like true Evie. So I just thought it'd be more fun to keep in like the true Evie outfits. And I thought that would be like really fun and cool. And plus, if I'm being completely honest, it is spooky season. So like, I really didn't want to like do an entire week of Evie outfits since I have such little time to be wearing all my spooky clothes. You know, like, Halloween is coming, and I'd rather like use the time to, because like technically when I was a week ago when I was at my dad's on vacation, I literally wore blue so much during that week, and I missed out on a lot of opportunities to wear spooky shirts, because the spooky shirts I had packed were either long sleeved or like were black, and just, it was hot down there and sunny most of the days, so I wore like crop tops and like stuff like that, and like blue shirts most of the time. So that was more like my blue week. I didn't want to like, so I was like, I already missed out kind of like on a week of wearing spooky like Halloween shirts then. I missed out on that. So I don't want to miss out on another week of like not wearing Halloween shirts, especially now that we're getting down to the wire of Halloween. So I'm not trying to be like lazy. I just truly did want to like reserve my time for like my Halloween shirts and whatnot. Like, even today I was low-key like, oh, do I really want to put this on? You'll see. And but it honestly, I have been wearing it as like a Halloween shirt too, because it works very well for a Halloween shirt. I love it very much, the shirt, my heart. Anyways, yeah, immediately never. I literally wrote out the intro so I wouldn't be going off on like wild tangents of ADHD, but I think I already did that, so whatever. Anywho, okay, so Anywho, here are my days being Evie, dressing as her. I hope you guys love them. I had a lot of fun. Literally the one dress, when I looked at it like in the store, I was like, Evie, and I like was so excited for the dress. I was like, oh my goodness. And then wearing it was so fun. It was like really literally like feeling like I was in like costume, like, and I just felt like cute little villain kid. Like, it was just so fun. I loved it. I hope you'll enjoy, and yes, I'm overanalyzing. Like, when I was writing this, I was literally overanalyzing, but I'm actually not right now. I'm actually not overanalyzing. I feel really good with everything I've said so far. And I laughed at myself because this was already I had already a pre-written thing. But yeah, enjoy. And also real quick, yes, day two, I am wearing shorts. Please don't come for me. It's not my fault they don't trust the villain kids in shorts. Okay? Okay. I love you guys. Enjoy.
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all? Slave in the magic mirror, come. From the farther space, through wind and darkness, I summon thee. Speak! Let me see thy face.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
You know what we should try? An icebreaker. You say something you really like about the other person, okay? I'll start. Harry. Great accent. Now you go.
Is she always this perky?
Oh, it wasn't really your turn, but thank you.
Okay, Evie, come here.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you.
You don't ever miss running wild and just breaking all the rules.
Like stealing and lying and fighting?
Yeah.
No.
What?
Why would we? Come here. Look at where we are. We're in Ordon. And we're Ordon girls now.
I didn't know what you were going through. I thought that you were fine. What did you have to hide? I didn't want to let you down.
This place is so
gross.
I know, right? Amazingly gross.
Ugh. I am going to need some serious sunscreen.
Yeah. This place is so
gross.
I know, right? Amazingly gross.
Ugh. I am going to need some serious sunscreen.
Yeah.
$1.29. We came in, we saw the deer, we got our corn. Now we gotta do, look at the, go to the stores, look at the Halloween display, which I love seeing that display, so I'm very excited. And I'm really excited because I obviously am dressed as the Evil Queen, so I'm gonna be very excited to take a picture with my girl Snow White, because they have her on display, which is really fun. And yeah, so it's very fun, very exciting. I love my nails.
Do you wanna go?
Okay.
This is Halloween. Oh, I love seeing Sally with her little mask on.
I only have a little mask.
Yes! We love seeing supportive humans. I like don't know where to go right now.
Here,
Hello. There's an Eagles mom and a Phillies.
Yeah.
Nevermore. Oh no.
Find the average atomic weight of silver.
It's 10:35. I'm getting dressed for the day, and I wanted to film this video where I dress as like Evie, and really only have like two outfits really to do that. And I've already worn one, and I was like, oh my god, today I should wear like the second day because I really want to make this a video. Even if it's just two outfits, I think it'll be like a fun video. And so I was like, oh, maybe I'll wear like the second outfit today. And I was like, but I really want to wear, like, I have more Halloween-y stuff to wear, and I really want to wear that. And I was going through my closet, and the first one of my Halloween shirts was this one. So I was like, it's fate, have to wear this one, and then I can work on the video, because I have footage filmed from the first day of me dressing like Evie, which today's Monday, that was Saturday, and now today's Monday. So I will just film the intro and then do like day one, day two, and then film an outro, because I already have, you know, day one. I'll film day two now, because we're going to go out soon to get Starbucks, so I'll film a little bit at the park, and then I will come home. Well, I have to study for an exam, but when I have time, I'll film an intro and an outro, and then boom, we'll be golden, baby, and then I'll just go through, edit it, and post it. I feel like silly it's only two outfits, but I think they're both really cute, and I think the footage will be fun enough where it's like, it doesn't matter that it's only two. You know, y'all already know I make my videos way too long as it is. You know what's funny? I was just wearing a Cruella nightgown, like that was my pajamas, and I'm just looking out of my closet that I have a Cruella shirt, so technically I could have done this with like each villain kit. Oh, I don't really have anything for Jafar though. I have Maleficent stuff, plenty. I even have Ursula stuff. Maleficent, Ursula, Evil Queen, yeah, obviously. Yeah, I just wouldn't have the hair color for all of them. A. B, the problemo is, B, I don't have Jafar. And here's the thing. That's not my fault. That's Disney's fault for not making more Jafar merch. And same with Jasmine and Aladdin. They don't make it. And it's funny, I was just watching a Soph video the other day where she even said, like, she was at Disneyland. And she's like, why don't they have any Aladdin merch? And especially because it was at the time when the new movie, the live action was being, like, coming out. So she's like, the live action's coming out. I don't even have merch. And I'm like,
flat as glass.
Hey guys, that's my Starbucks drink. So as you saw, I was making TikToks, like, as Evie. That's what I did the other day, and I wanted to find more audios of Evie while I still have the blue hair. And just something I wanted to do, I was going to do in the car, but then, like, just time went on and I just didn't. So I was like, I'll do it when I get home. And now that I've Chilling Like a Villain stuck in my head and I want to listen to a full song, I was like, ooh, let me do it now since I've taken this extremely long break from studying. Of, like, just jamming to Descendants songs. I feel like Evie would totally be, like, a Starbucks girl, so. Sorry, I'm trying to get the apple in. Hey, look, I got Mel right there. Evie and Mal would totally be, like, that friendship goals of, like, Evie would wear, like, little Mal ears to Disney and Mal would wear Evie ears. Like, they would be that friendship goals. You know what I mean? Like, ah, they're so cute. Oh, some hardcore tap, tap, tapping. Tap, tap in. I don't really know the words. I'm so sorry. Well, to tap, tap, tap in. I think I've listened to that song once. I just hear it a lot on, like, TikTok and stuff like that, you know what I mean? Okay. And look how iconic this queen is. Ooh, it's making it. Okay, cool. So something I realized in the car. Wait, let me full screen this. Duh. Okay, one thing I noticed in the car is...
Y'all, please forgive the dust. I don't understand how there is so much, but it's snowing back here!
My hair is more like Descendants 1 Evie, where it wasn't very vibrant. It was a lot of brown, like, dark hair with blue hair. And, like, even though, like, so now the lighting's kind of making it look greener, but, like, it does look... Evie blue. Like, I know, like, sometimes I look, my hair is like that like, what's that dress? The dress that was, literally last night Billie Eilish was, like, going off because everybody kept saying her shoes were pink and white and they're green and white and she was, like, going off. And I'm like, that's, like, my hair. My hair just looks like it's green in some color, in some lightings, and some lightings it looks bluer. Like, my hair is just, like, the hair that you can never actually tell the color because it's just always, like, switching in the lighting. I love it for me.
Tell you something you can't trust. Everybody's got a weak side. I didn't think that you could live in a business. Watch your words so you can get it right. You need to drag your feet. You need to nod your head. You need to lean back. Slip through the cracks. You need to not care.
You need to not stare. You need a whole lot of help. You need to not be yourself. You wanna be cool? Let me show you how. You break the rules. Let me show you how. I want you to stand. I want you to feel it. You'll be chilling, chilling. Oh, chilling like a villain.
A villain, teach you how to disappear.
I could just totally see Evie going to the parks with little Mal ears and vice versa. We got the Evil Queen. We got Maleficent. We got Evie hair. It's a vibe. Hello. Hello. Oh. I'm trying to, like, think about, like, what Starbucks would be called if... Oh. I just watched this kid fall outside. Oh, little buddy just got right back up. Good for him. Oh, he's so cute. He's got a happy meal. Good for this man. He's living his best life. Can I be him? Anyways, I'm trying to think of what Starbucks would be called if, like, Descendants had it. I think they've mentioned it before. I know in Ever After High, they had, like, a Starbucks-type place they went to. Actually, I read a conspiracy theory that Ever After High was based off, coffee place. That, like, Disney apparently, like, ripped off Ever After High and copied them. It's the Hocus Latte at Book and Local Cafe. They'd get the Hocus Latte. And it was called Book and Cafe. The Book and Local Cafe. God bless Google. God bless. So, of course, like, I have to do, oopsies. I have to do Space Between, which always makes me cry listening to. I was actually asked on TikTok to cover this song. I guess you could kind of say this is my semi-cover of the song. Sorry, that's like such an odd angle. I'm also not trying to make this long. That's why I'm not doing the full songs, because like there's a lot of songs I'd like to do. And I'm trying not to do the full song. I'm just trying to like do bits of each song. Mainly like the Evie part, since this video is dedicated to Evie. I wish I had done this video with Mal, but oh well. Life's unfortunate. Oh, it's time to cry. Wait, real quick. Let's smile with this picture. Okay, anyways, time to cry. Let's cry. I love this shirt. I've had this shirt for a good time. I actually met the Evil Queen in this shirt. Let me just insert it right, boop, right there. Yeah, I met the Evil Queen in this shirt. An icon. It was my, I love meeting the Evil Queen. She does, the last time I met her though, was it the very last time or the second to last time? I can't remember, but the one time I met her, she actually like genuinely scared me, but I was really obnoxious. I felt really bad. Like it's a vlog. You guys can watch that vlog. Like I was just really excited, and I think I was just way too excited. I was on some type of high, and I was like just way too much energy probably for her, or she was just really good at her job and she was just really scary, but I felt like she was probably annoyed with me. Probably was. I can be annoying. Anyways, I'm not trying to make this video. I'm like, I always have a problem making videos too long, so like, yeah. It also makes me think of my cousin G. Hi G, I love you.
I didn't know what you were going through. I thought that you were fine. What did you have to hide? I didn't want to let you down. But the truth is out. It's tearing me apart. Not listening to my heart. I really had to go. And I would never stop you, even though it changed. And you can find me in the space between. When two worlds come to be, I'll never be out of reach. Cause you're a part of me, so you can find me in the space between. You'll never be alone, no matter where you go. We can meet in the space between. And nothing can stay the same. It's growing pain. Be proud of all your stars that make you who you are.
Not to interrupt, but like that part low-key reminds me of like the Fosters like intro song. Maybe it's just me.
I know you have to stay. I'll never really leave you. That's the best I'm in the space between. When two worlds come to me, I'll never be out of reach. Cause you're a part of me, so you can find me in the space between. I'll never be alone. No matter where you go, we can meet in the space between. There are no words left to say. I know you gotta find your place. Not the end. I'm proud of who I am. Even if we're worlds apart, you're still in my heart. It will always be you and me. Yeah. You can find me in the space between. Cause your world comes to me. I'll never be out, I'll never be out of reach. So pardon me so you can find me in the space between. You'll never be alone, no matter where you go. We can meet in the space between. Yeah, right away though. We can meet in the space between.
Time for this iconic bop. Like, it'll never not be iconic. Okay, not this. This is a commercial. I really need to go back to studying. Oh my lordy. Oh my goodness. And I had the thought of, like, I'm gonna have a blue outfit for the intro and outro. So then this outfit can still be a surprise and you can get a bonus blue outfit. I'm not gonna lie, please don't come for me. I am the biggest Descendants fan you would ever meet. I love Descendants with all my heart. I literally watched it on, like, I watched it early because, like, if you had, like, the Disney Channel app on your phone, you could watch it, like, earlier than it was released. Like, I'm the biggest Descendants fan there is. Like, I love Descendants with all my heart. I'm one of their biggest fans. I'm never, like, crediting myself with being the biggest fan because, like, I don't know, I feel like it's a hard title for someone to claim in life. But I do like to say I'm one of the biggest fans because I do feel like I'm very much one of their biggest fans. Like, I love Descendants with all my heart, etc., etc. But here's the tea, and I did say this before. When I first watched Descendants 3, I loved it, but I was not completely sold on a lot of the songs. I didn't like a lot of them. Now here's the thing. I hated Queen of Mean. I hated that song when I first listened to it. Now it's one of my favorite songs off the album. And that's always what happens to me. It's like, I'll hate a song. Not always. Okay, here's the thing. As I always say, guys, with me, it depends. Sometimes with songs, I don't like them at first. And then if I listen to it a couple times, I'll love it. You know what I mean? It becomes my obsession. Like, I listened to Queen of Mean and, like, nothing else for, like, the longest time. Like, that's all I listened to for, like, months. I don't know, weeks, months. No, months. Months is accurate. Anyways, maybe if I listen to One Kiss more, I'd like it more. But when it came to watching the movie, I was like, what the fridge is this scene? I cannot comprehend. Especially, here's the thing. Here's also what adds to my frustration, and that's why, like, I end up liking songs the more I listen to them after the movie. It's like, you know, we were, like, in the middle of, like, conflict when this song happened. Like, we were trying to figure some stuff out. So the fact that they just interrupted the plot with a very unnecessary song, no offense, but, like, it was very unnecessary, and it was very odd that just all of a sudden she's, like, singing about needing to kiss this man's. And she doesn't even go through with it. It was just like, okay, why did I waste my time on this? But just, yeah, I'm just gonna, it's like, it was like this with Frozen 2 as well. Like, I was like, oh my God, why is there another song? We need to know what happened. Like, Olaf just literally flurried away. Please stop. With the, like, it wasn't even like I don't like the, it wasn't even like I didn't like the songs. It's just when you're like, sometimes with watching a musical and like it's a conflict musical where like there's like something big going down, I feel like everyone relates like that, where it's like, no, not another song, we need to know what's gonna happen, we need to know. Because a lot of times the songs don't evolve the plots, they kind of just make the plot go a little, they kind of like are like freeze the plot for a song and then continue the plot. Sometimes, not always. Anyways, basically what I'm trying to say is, at first I did not like this song. And I haven't really listened to it since. That's kind of been my like problem with the third album. Since I didn't like a lot of them when I first watched the movie, I never really went back and listened to a lot of them. The only ones I really know / listen to. So the ones I listen to are Mal's solo song at the towards the end, Break This Down, VK Day. What is that song called? I forget. See, like, that's the thing. Like, I remember, like, driving to California and back, like, maybe more back with Gianna, and she kept playing Descendants 3 songs. So I'm like, gee, I don't mean to be mean, but I don't know any of these songs. I know, like, 3 of these songs off the album. Descendants 3. No, don't get me wrong. I loved Descendants 3. I just didn't always love the song. So yeah, Queen of Mean, love that song. Night Falls, I don't really listen to it, but I've heard it since. And every time I hear it, I'm like, a bop. I do really enjoy it. Like, you guys saw, I made like a TikTok to it. I do actually enjoy it. Do What You Gotta Do is, I remember liking it when I watched the movie. I haven't really listened to it that much since. I think I tried listening to the one day. Good to Be Bad, that's what the song called. I do listen to Good to Be Bad. It's good to be bad, and we're proof of that. Used to be, and we're over that. But yeah, One Kiss, never really been my gal. But maybe if I listen to it more, maybe I'll like it. My Once Upon a Time is a bop. If I do declare, I do kind of feel like it's the best song off the album. Maybe shouldn't put that out there yet. Okay, let's see, like, this will be the test if I like One Kiss. So basically, I'm just gonna, yeah. I don't really know the words. Oh, also, I haven't watched Descendants 3 since it aired, and, like, that's been kind of, like, my goal to, like, watch it again, because, like, I really do want to watch it again. I kind of like want to have a marathon. Every time I saw G this summer, my cousin Gianna, we kept saying we're going to have a marathon. It just never happened. So hopefully the next time we're together, we'll actually be able to watch them. Yes. I'm so sorry, but back to what I was, like, the reason, like, I wasn't even going to include the song, but I was like, it's Evie's solo song, and I was going to do, like, a song from every movie. How could I not include Evie's solo song? But yeah, so when I was watching it, I was like, what is the point of this scene? Like, no offense, like, this is no shade to the movie, this is no shade to Sophia Carson, I think she's an amazing voice, but I was just like, what is the scene? I just want to know what's going to happen. Uma's me, like, during the scene. Uma's like, okay, let's get this scene over with. I have no patience for this. That is me in this. That is me in a nutshell with this scene. One kiss, it all comes down. See, I don't even know the words. Hi, Editing Katie here. This is actually a really good song. Like, when I'm listening to it without hearing, like, without watching the music video, like, this is a really good song. So, just wanted to put that out there. I'm probably gonna end up listening to this more, because, like, right now I'm, like, jamming to it as I'm editing.
But Sophia Carson is very fierce in this scene. I'm here for it.
Uma Mal in this part is just so funny. They're like, oh my god, are you gonna, like, do this? Or, like, Uma Mal is basically, like, everyone watching this movie at this point, because I feel like am I wrong about this? I feel like other people felt like this way too, of like, okay, let's speed this up, girl. Either kiss him or don't kiss him. We got, like, stuff to do. There's some evil Audrey rampaging. Like, we gotta go. But it is a good song. I feel like I could, like, be down. She said, yeah, like, it was just a really weird scene, in my opinion. It was just very odd. And, like, just really unnecessary, because she doesn't even end up kissing him in the end. But anyways.
If I'm remembering properly, it does kind of make sense for Evie's character development. But it still was a very stretched out scene. You know?
I digress, because we could be here forever dissecting Descendants with me. Anyways. And we're proof of that. You stood. Dude, I swear to God, that's the guy that, like, would. That's the same voice of the guy that would do, like, Disney Channel commercials.
And the other VKs will collect the applications today and announce who gets to go to Orida Prep.
I got my application.
I have mine right here.
Please pick me now.
I don't have my application. I'm so sorry. I'm kidding. Who's in charge of making these murals of them? They are never accurate.
From the north to the south, from the east to the west, lost boys, lost girls, you all know you're the best.
Hit the streets, here's your chance, turn it up, now's your chance. It's time to get up on your feet and dance.
Everybody wanna be like us, everybody wanna be like us.
All the boys from Orlando
and the girls, cause they know what's up. Your life could change today. Your life could change today.
These streets named after us because we paved the way.
Everyone, come and take your shot.
But I was bad.
It's good to be bad.
And we're proof of that.
Used to be lost, now we're over that.
Used to just back, now we're kids on that. Remember that.
Bad. If you got pride, raise your
feet. Raise
side to side.
But truly, I do feel like if I watched Descendants 3 again, and, like, I just listened to the album more, I feel like I would end up, like, growing to, like, love every single song. Like, here's the thing, and, like, I said this in my review, so I'm not, like, I don't know, I just don't want anyone to think I'm, like, a hater or anything, it's just my opinion. I did feel like the soundtracks 2, 1, and 2 were better than 3. Like, I don't know. I felt like song-wise, the songs, I felt like 2 was superior. T. See, back to that, my hair looks like changes color. Look, you can see the dark blue more in this, and then like, it's just wild. Okay, hey guys. Okay, real quick, I just want to say, while I was out eating lunch, I remembered that I actually wore this outfit a couple years ago. I think like 2017. And I remember, I think even then I was like, low-key, like, was that like Evie vibes? I don't think so. But I felt really cute. But now looking at it, I'm like, oh my gosh, Evie vibes. Because I actually got my red flannel out yesterday to like wear, do like an outfit with the red flannel, but I didn't end up doing it. But basically I was like, oh, Evie wouldn't even wear like flannel. But this outfit gives me a lot of Evie vibes. And even though I would not see her wearing flannel, maybe she was like doing an outdoorsy look, maybe? I don't know. Anyways, it just gave me like Evie vibes. And I was even at like an orchard that day. So I literally posed as like the evil queen. Like, I'm telling you guys, it gave me like evil queen, like, not like evil queen vibes, but it gave me like villainous vibes. Like, I felt really cute. And that dress always makes me feel really cute. So I just wanted to quickly throw that in because I thought it was just a nice little extra bonus look that I did a couple years ago without even trying. And it was just really cute. And I was at an apple orchard, and I just think that's just so fitting since, you know, Evie is the daughter of the evil queen. You know, literally what I'm wearing, poison apple, which when I wore this to meet Her Majesty and Dopey and Grumpy and Snow, I found it so funny. It was the first time, it was last year, and it was the first time I ever met Snow and Grumpy. It was the first time I ever met, well, I met Snow before, but it was the first time I met Snow at that location. It was the first time I met Grumpy and Dopey and Evil Queen. Funny thing is, Dopey was terrified of me because of the shirt. Grumpy was like, how dare you for wearing that shirt. Evil Queen, I don't know if she commented on, no, I think she liked my shirt. The only one that was bothered by my shirt, I mean, the only one that was not bothered by my shirt was Evil Queen and literally Snow White herself. Snow White was so unbothered, like, she could care less. I love it. I love that for her. She's an unbothered queen. And honestly, I'm like, bro, she's so unbothered. This is the shirt she literally wears in Wreck-It Ralph 2, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is the shirt she just chills in for fun. Like, what an icon, just casually wearing the thing that killed her. Well, tried to kill her. You know what I mean? Anyways, it just made me laugh how unbothered she was by my shirt. You know what I mean? Everyone at, like, you know, Grumpy and Dopey had a huge problem with it. And then the girl that should have had the most problem with it didn't care. She was just happy to meet me. It's all a joke. I'm just kidding. So anyways, yeah, so
I need to study. I didn't want to.
Let me tell you something you can really trust. Everybody.
Yay! Hello, folks. Welcome to. We're gonna have to fire him. Happy Halloween!
You got that, but I think by the time I ask you to help you, it's too late.
We're gonna party like this. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I appreciate you watching this, and if you made it to the end, congratulations. You're a true villain kid. But yes, I love you guys so much. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate your love and support, and just watching just means the world to me. So thank you. I really do hope you guys enjoyed. I very much enjoyed making this. And I love you all with all my heart. Bye!